My name is Professor Harsh Chadha. I'm speaking to you from Dubai in the United Arab Emirates. Today, I want to speak to you on a subject which is very different than the one I spoke last time. A few months back, I spoke on a subject called the color of money. Today, I'd like to speak on the color of human beings. Why is the color of human beings always been an issue in the history of mankind? Why is it considered to be a distinctive factor to divide humanity? Is the color of a human being really that important to divide a human beings, to judge them based on purely their color? I don't think so. Does one color differentiate from the other? Does one color give better rights to the other? I don't think so. I think all colors in humanity are equal, because all human beings have the same color of blood, and they are built structurally the same way. They have the same two eyes, the same two ears, the same brain. They may have different features. Some may coming from Africa, some from Mongolia, some from China, but still the color does not make a distinct relationship to who they are. They are who they are. For a long, long time, the issue of color has been brought up through the civilized world. In Europe, in America, to disintegrate people, in my country where I come from, in India, we have a caste system, so they automatically segregate our people. But in modern society, there was no other way to segregate people but based on color. Just because you were dark in color did not give you the right to go to a school. Just because you were dark in color did not give you a right to vote. And because you did not vote, you could not have any power in the country to represent your people. Therefore, the white people were able to control the dark people because of this single factor, that the dark people were never given the right to vote. The right to vote for the dark people was a huge battle and an upward task for them. And this was fought for the dark people by Martin Luther King. He fought this on their behalf in a non-violent way, right up to the Justice of America, and took it to the President of America, and finally convinced him to pass a bill in Congress that gave equal rights to every person in the United States. This bill was the beginning of freedom. This bill was the beginning of the word equality. Because every immigrant who landed in America, no matter what his color was, he was judged on an equal basis and a legal basis, in law and in every manner. But even though the law has supported, and even though people like Malcolm X and Martin Luther King did a lot to uplift the dark society of America, and even though Obama is doing a lot in that direction, but beneath the surface, there are a lot of things working against the dark society. And they still don't believe that they are the ones who should have equal rights with them. But the truth is that everything that America has is because of the dark people. It's they who came to the country. It's they who taught them how to dance. It's they who taught them how to sing. It's they who taught them everything. From the cotton fields, to the mining, to everything, it was the dark people who took it on them to build the railroads, to build the skyscrapers, to build the huge projects of America, to be able to sustain the American dream. So, let's not forget that taking the model of America, and if we take it into a different country like Brazil or South America, or if we take it into another country like China, or even another country like Thailand, human beings segregate themselves. They segregate themselves for one simple reason, and that is they want to control each other. They want to control each other because they want dominance. They want dominance because they can have control, and through control can have power. There is a famous march that Martin Luther King did with his dark people from the town of Selma to Montgomery in Alabama state, in which a lot of people were hurt and a lot of people were innocent people were killed. But he did it in non-violent. He was not violent. When he approached the bridge and the troopers started threatening to stop, he only kneeled and prayed. And the Lord told him, "Take your people back. Don't waste your blood on these people. Take your people back. And when the right time comes, come the correct way." He built so much pressure on the President of America that the President of America had no way but to accept what he said, because there was no going back. He is the biggest activist of our times and one of the greatest civil rights Father. What we see now in Tiananmen Square, what we see now in so many situations, like in Ukraine, where people come together and demonstrate in a non-violent manner, that then turns out to be violent, it originated from Martin Luther King. So yes, it is good. It is good that we must express ourselves, we must have our freedom, we must fight for equality, but there is a way to do it. We must do the right thing, the right way. I would only ask myself one question. If Neil Armstrong, when he landed on the moon, met another person, would it matter to him if that person was black or if he was white? Space is the only place where there is no color, because everything is dark. Everything in space is only one color, black. It is void. Nothing can be seen in space unless there is a reflection of light. But do you think this would be viable for people who live in other planets? Do you think they govern their people based on color? Do you think they govern themselves based on just the color of your skin, to define how good you are or how bad you are? There is no mention in any of the religious books about the color of skin for the human being. Whether it's the Bible or the Quran or even my book, the Gita, it does not mention the color of the skin of human beings is superior or which one is inferior. But in my opinion, I think that we've trained ourselves to differentiate ourselves. We have lost the common ground that nature has provided us. Nature built us the same way, but we chose to be different. Thank you.
Llegaste hasta mí como un atardecer de otoño.